Hello, mon nom c'est Luc Beignoche et ça va être la seule partie en français. En fait, what I'm presenting you today, it's AI advisors. What we do is to empower the investor in you. And the way we do it, and I need the clicker for that, the way we do it, it's by allowing you to invest using artificial intelligence. Why? Because you keep controlling it. It has no conflict of interest. It can learn how to outperform the market. You can personalize it, it's simple and affordable. So at the end, artificial intelligence is the perfect advisor. So a lot of people, a lot of investors know Warren Buffett because he was very good, very, very good in the previous century. A less known mathematician is James Simons. He has a fund, he started that fund in 1988 using artificial intelligence. And he has been able to do 35% a year in average since then. And since 2000, he is beating Warren Buffett and the stock market. So AI is better adapted to the financial market of today. But the problem is that retail investors, they don't have this technology. What they have, it's obsolete solutions. So because of that, they are making between 3% to 6%, while the firm are able to make a lot more than that. So basically, what they have today, it's like human advice and social trading. The problem with that is that it is unreliable. Then after that, they can use robo-advisor. But that's one-size-fits-all solution based on technologies from the 1950s, like Markowitz. Also, they can use quantitative tools, but they are complex and time-consuming. If they don't have the time to understand those tools, then they can buy algorithms on Marketplace for high price. On our side, we want to provide simple, affordable, and personalized artificial intelligence. And that's the kind of performance you can get. So this is an example with gold. So it's a 10% premium with only 16 transactions per year. So not a lot of transactions. Then another example, Standard & Poor 500, 9% premium with 9 transactions per year. And we can do that with any stock in the stock market. Why? How do we do that? We basically run algorithms, a lot of them, a big race of algorithms. We use big data and machine learning to understand and find out the best strategies out there. Then after that, we study and analyze using AI again, what is the relationship between the past return and the future return? Because what we want to do is to provide you the top 5% strategies that are able to predict the market. So, all the system is based on 2 billion metrics per stock every day. And no human can do that. That's how we provide the buy and sell signals. And we can even tell you why you should buy and sell. It's not a black box AI. So on the user side, they build their portfolio and then they fine-tune a strategy around it. So in this case, for example, conservative in China, because we want to limit the risk in a risky market. Then you go and you simulate your strategy in a few seconds. In this example, a real example, 7% premium on 13 stock. Then we recommend that you do paper trading. And in this case, after 15 weeks, you're able to get some good returns with low transaction rate. We also propose that you do competition with other users in the platform to compare and benchmark. And it's only when you are ready to execute the strategy that you pay. And it's $5 per stock per month. And if you're ready even to take your proven strategies and sell it, you can upgrade your account. So, wow. Okay, that's good. Not on this screen. Sorry for that. So the thing is, basically, the world is the addressable market. Okay, why? Because the technology learned by itself, so it can learn on any stock exchange, any stock. But actually, we are looking for something very smaller than that at the beginning. So 100K users with our own brand doing B2C. And then a white label beside that, so a B2B2C, in order to be able to go and address more customer base out there. We are 4 co-founders. Me, I am CEO and AI architect. Actually, I started to work at IBM at 17 years old. At IBM, we have Carl, responsible of the R&D on the AI, GF, responsible of the product, and then Prabhu, responsible of the operations. And we have an excellent advisory panel. We are currently in beta only with a few users. What we're targeting is to launch a new version of the app based on the feedback with user competitions, and we'll do the marketing around that to target 100,000 users next year and do the seed round. So, do you give me another 5 seconds?
Mm-hmm.
No?
That's it, I'm sorry.
Okay, I leave it there.
Très bien, monsieur. Très bien.
Sorry.
Bonjour, Luc, belle présentation.
Bonjour.
Have you ever thought about, you know, profit sharing instead of monthly fees in your model?
Yeah, but the thing is, at the beginning, we don't want to deal with regulations. So the thing is, we don't want to do asset under management, if this is what you're talking about. So we just want to provide that, because the mission of the company, actually, is to democratize artificial intelligence and bring it to everybody. We believe that it is highly important that people can control the AI by themselves, not only through a company, like it is today in most of the business model. So then the idea is that we don't want to manage the money for people, we want to leave people, personalize the kind of portfolio they want to do, and then use AI by themselves.
So on the algorithm side, what I understood from your presentation is you select your own stocks and criteria, and you're using robot advisor or algorithms to,
yeah,
to make the transaction automatically after that.
No, at the beginning, we are not doing a transaction automatically, but in the white label offering, this is one feature we want to offer. But at the beginning, what we are doing right now with the current app is just providing the information for you to do it with an API, so if you want to automate it by yourself with your broker, you can.
Okay.
Shadi. Thanks for the presentation. Can you talk to us a little bit about your machine learning algorithm? Who's developing it? How will you protect it? And what makes it so good? This is pretty impressive what you're describing here. You basically give.
So first of all, to make it so good, it's very hard to benchmark.
Okay.
Very, very hard to benchmark, because the thing is that at the end, all the other companies using AI and financial, they are very secretive about it. Very secretive. One thing I can say that we have that I have not seen so far in any of the other financial institutions is the fact that we can understand what the AI is thinking. The way it is done, we can tell you the reason why we are telling you to buy or sell, let's say, Google. So that is one thing for which we are better for sure, because I've not seen it before. Then, very difficult to benchmark. The second part of the question, can you say again, sorry?
So there's three parts of it.
Mm-hmm.
How are you developing it so that you are essentially making this available? Will you protect it as well, because barriers to entry for others?
Yeah, definitely it's protected, but we are not thinking even about patent at this point in time. It's just about trade secret. And the way we protect it actually is that it is divided. It's modular, so not everybody is working on the same piece of it. So actually, I'm the only one getting the overview on it. So that's a way to protect it. Then the other part, sorry, I missed it again.
It's okay.
That's it? Okay.
Yeah, you covered it. Please.
I'm just trying to understand your path to scale. So
yep.
you're going to go B2C.
Mm-hmm.
Is that correct? You're going directly to the consumer.
Yeah, the B2C is there to develop basically the technology and get traction, but there really to develop the technology with early adopters.
Okay.
What we want to do, the biggest channel, it's really a white label.
Yeah.
Channel with
yeah.
brokers.
Because
and that's what we are asking for. It's basically to have a partnership with the first broker who is ready to get AI to its customer base in order to develop that white label offering.
That makes more sense to me, because if you truly have an algorithm that can beat the market,
mm-hmm.
like you're saying.
It's not one, but yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, well, multiple algorithms that can
yeah.
beat the market.
Mm-hmm.
My assumption would be that would be a very valuable conversation. I mean, if you can prove your model out, if you can
mm-hmm.
successfully prove your model out, and you should be able to do that with data from, you know, with historical data
mm-hmm.
from a financial services provider. So why wouldn't you go directly to FI and try to prove out your model, to do
yeah.
a proof of concept?
So for awareness and credibility.
Start your own venture fund, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But for basically awareness and credibility, we'll do that. We'll benchmark. So first, the competitions, that's the reason why I want to do it. The competition with users, it's basically there to find out how users are using it, the same way our users are using Netflix, in order to find out how they can use and leverage AI. That's one thing we want to study. The second thing is basically doing it with a broker. It will be a lot easier, because then we can even benchmark what our AI is doing compared to their investors. We can compare their transaction with our transaction. So that's exactly where we want to go. But we really want right now to do the B2C as well. So we have some, we are close. We need to be close to our market. That's our goal for now. And then do the B2C, the B2B2C as well.
It just seems like what you really need is data. You're going to find bigger data sets elsewhere than the B2C market.
Yeah.
Super cool. Awesome job.